Hi everyone, welcome to Dataverse Academy. In today's video, we will learn how we can use the get metadata activity of data pipeline.
Log into your Microsoft Fabric account, then click on below left hand corner, then click on data warehouses, then click on workspaces, then click on new, then click on data pipeline. Then provide name to your data pipeline. Then click on create. Then click on get metadata activity. So using get metadata activity, you can get the metadata of a table file from lakehouse and table metadata from data warehouse and metadata of external sources. Basically, metadata means if I talk about tables metadata, it means how many columns I have in that table, what is the script of that table, if that table exists or not, and in case of files, type of file, number of columns, whether it exists or not, and in case of folder, whether that folder exists or not, how many files we have in that folder. Now provide name and description to your get metadata activity. Then click on settings. We are going to read the metadata of a lakehouse table and file. We need to click on workspace. Then select lakehouse. Then click on your lakehouse. Root folder, you can select either tables or file. For now, I'll select tables. Select your table. In field list, click on new. In argument, you can see I have column count, exist and structure. Using column count, you can find out how many columns I have in that table. Using exist, you can check whether my table is exist or not. Using structure, you can check the structure of your table. So for now, I'll choose exist. If that table is exist, I'll get true. Else I'll get false. Save your data pipeline. Click on home. Then click on save. Now let's run it. Click on run. Our pipeline is succeeded. Let's check the detail. Click on it. Here you can see in output true. It means that particular table is exist. Close it. Now we will check the metadata of data warehouse. In workspace data store type, choose data warehouse. Then select your data warehouse. Then click on edit. Now intentionally, I'll provide a name of a table which does not exist. Schema name is DBO. Table name is dummy. Then click on new. Then choose argument type as exist. As I know this table doesn't exist in my data warehouse, I should get false in my output. Let's save it. Now run it. Our pipeline is completed successfully. Let's check the output. You can see I got false. Close it. Now what I'll do, as I know this table doesn't exist in my data warehouse, I'll use the output of get metadata activity, then I'll create this table in my data warehouse. For that I'll use if condition activity and script activity. Click on activities, then click on if condition, then map it. Then click on your if condition activity, then click on activities. Here we need to provide our condition. Using this condition, if condition activity will find out whether the condition is true or false. Click on add dynamic content. Here you can see we have activities output. So we are going to use the get metadata activity output. Click on get metadata of lakehouse exists. Then click on OK. As we know, we are getting false through this activity. So what we need to do, under false, click on it. We will use script activity. If you are not familiar with the script activity, please watch my other video. I'll put link in the description. Then click on settings. Then click on workspace. Then select your data warehouse. Then click on non-query. Here we will create a script for our table. Create table dbo.dummy colon varchar pen. We are going to create a dummy table with only one column. Now go back to your pipeline. Click on it. Under 2, we are not going to do anything. Let's save our mapping. Click on home. Then click on save. Now run it. Click on run. Our pipeline is completed successfully. Let's check the detail. In the get metadata, we got false. So accordingly, our false condition will run. And under false condition, we have a script activity. To verify the script activity output, we will check our data warehouse. Click on your workspace, then click on your data warehouse. Here you can see a table is created under DBO schema. That's it. Thank you for watching this video.